Okay, so currently we have a small issue with our system in that when a user fills in some data, you can see here, using aliens as an example, it's filled in lots of different ways. So capital A, capital A and L, lowercase. Okay, so the problem we're going to come across is if we run our file and we search, so search for a film, and if we type in aliens with a capital A, it will pull up the three people who are going to see aliens with capital A's. But the problem is, if we look at our list, which I've printed up here, so Peter Paul is going to see aliens as well, but because he's put a small A in, it's not come up. Johnny Briggs is also seeing aliens, but because he's put a big L, that's not coming up in the search. So we need a way of being able to standardise everything, so it will only search for films with that name, with no matter what case people type in, so lower, upper, all that sort of stuff. So we can put a little bit of code in which will sort that out for us. Now here, this is the search film function. Okay, so just underneath the bit where the user types in their film in the input, and we can put this bit of code that says lookup equals lookup dot lower and two brackets. And what that's doing, we've used the variable name lookup to be the whatever the user types in, so aliens for example, and then this bit of code will convert whatever they type into lowercase. Okay, so even if they type it all in caps, it will go to lowercase, okay, when they search for the film. Now, what we need to do as well is we need to make sure that when they actually book the film in the first place, the film is also all in lowercase. Okay, so here where we've got film equals input, at the end of that, if we just put dot lower and two brackets, and we've done it twice, remember, because we've got the two options for if the booking reference is the same. So we need to do it down here as well. There it is, film equals input dot lower. Okay, so what should happen now is no matter what they type in, it will always come up in lowercase. So if I run this, and we'll do an example of, so let's book a film to start with, and Smith, John, and let's type it all in capitals. Okay, and what should happen is when we run this and look at the CSV file, it should make it all lowercase. Let's just close that CSV there and we'll submit the booking. Okay, and if we just go ahead and find that CSV again, there it is. So what should happen when we open this up, we should see, it's just loading it, we should see that, who do we type in? John Smith, aliens should be in lowercase. Okay, so let's just check that. Okay, there it is. Good. So lowercase. So what this means, I hadn't done this at the start of my my testing here, but if I just change these so they're all lowercase, what this should mean that from now on, any film that is entered into the database will go in lowercase. Okay. So what this means is, let's just get rid of those capitals. What this means is when I do a search on my film, just want to export this to a CSV quickly, it should bring up all of the instances of aliens, okay, no matter what case I type in. Okay, so we'll just save that. Okay, good. So I'm getting rid of that and we'll test it. Okay, so let's run the code again, and this time we'll do a search. Okay, so search. So if I type in aliens with maybe all caps this time, what it should do is the code over here will convert it, just this bit here, this will convert it to lowercase, so it will match up with all the lowercase instances in the CSV file. So let's see. Okay, there we go. So even though I've typed in caps, it's now searched for all of the people going to see that film. So no matter how we type in the film name, as long as we spell it correctly, the case doesn't matter. It will record the film as lowercase and it will search it as lowercase. So we should find all the instances of that film.